Welcome back to CIE's How to AV as we bring you our top 10 tips for choosing the right door intercom device for your system. There's a vast range of door intercoms available in the market to choose from, so understanding how and why each system would be used is key to helping find the right choice of product with the most successful results. The How to AV team of experts have put together our top 10 tips for choosing the perfect device for your door entry and access control system. So tip one, how many intercoms are going to be required? A door intercom system requires a minimum of two endpoint stations, a calling unit located at the entrance and an answering device located indoors. And for a small home, a one-to-one system like this may be fine. However, most door intercom systems need to provide multiple entrances and exits for multiple apartments, zones or offices. Therefore, to meet the demands of the system, you'll need to conduct a survey to confirm the total number of call points, access points and answering points. Tip two, is it indoor or outdoor devices? Where are your intercom devices going to be located? Outdoors, where weather conditions and the risk of vandalism may need to be considered, or lower risk indoor locations. Outdoor intercoms require an IP rating, otherwise known as ingress protection rating. An IP rating signifies the product's suitability to withstand long-term adverse weather conditions. Outdoor intercoms may also offer a rain hood back box to give greater protection from weather conditions. As well as being IP rated, devices may also have an IK rating, otherwise known as impact protection rating. IK rated products are often referred to as vandal resistant, which is down to the fact that IK rated devices can usually withstand higher levels of abuse. Therefore, outdoor intercoms are usually recommended to have an IK rating as well as an IP rating. Indoor intercoms may have a lower IP rating or none at all, as they're much less prone to harsh conditions. However, IP rated and even IK rated devices may be specified in high moisture or high risk internal locations. Tip three, audio only or audio and video intercom. All intercoms feature audio calling, which allows visitors and residents to communicate with each other remotely to identify the visitor before allowing or denying access. For better identification of visitors and increased security, door intercoms can also feature video, of course. This allows the resident to visually see the visitor as well as hearing their voice. Some intercoms also allow for third-party video surveillance camera integration, which increases the security even further by offering additional or wider viewing angles of the entrance to the building. Tip 4, door intercom or access control. To decide if a door intercom or an access control reader is needed is really straightforward. It all depends on whether communication is required to identify the visitor before granting access. And if the answer is yes, communication is required, then a door intercom featuring video and or audio is the right choice. However, if access can be gained without the need to communicate with someone using authentication methods such as RFID cards, PIN codes and smartphone access, then an access reader may be the correct choice of device. Tip 5, what call functionality is required? Call functionality, in simple terms, is how the visitor to the front door calls the relevant resident inside the apartment or building. Door intercoms are available with a range of different call function options, which includes call buttons, digital phone book, and more recently, voice assist. So call buttons, single or multiple call buttons are used for simple call functionality. This method, however, is limited in the number of call destinations. For instance, using individual call buttons would not be suitable in a 100 apartment building, where a digital phone book would offer a more appropriate solution to managing large numbers of contacts. Digital phone books provide many similar functions to a smartphone and are extremely flexible. This method supports high numbers of destinations and allows digital labelling of apartments by names or apartment numbers. Digital phone books also provide easy search facilities and often have the ability to add logos and images to the contact if required. And digital phone books are ideal for multi-resident buildings such as MDUs, apartment blocks, multi-user office buildings and student accommodation. Another piece of smartphone functionality finding its way into the door intercom sector is voice assist, allowing visitors to simply ask the intercom to call apartment 319 or call Jane Smith, for example, without the need to press any buttons or touch the screen. Tip 6, what access authentication methods are required? Door intercom systems are available with a variety of authentication methods. Knowing which ones are required helps in the process of choosing the right intercom solution. There are a range of authentication methods. RFID uses cards or key fobs to gain authorised access. PIN code access uses a registered numeric PIN entered into the device's keypad. Biometric authentication uses a person's unique biological identity as an authentication key for access. QR code scanning is ideal for temporary access, as a unique QR code can be generated with limited use settings and sent straight to a visitor's phone to be scanned for entry. NFC uses similar technology to RFID. However, instead of key fobs or cards, the user makes use of their smartphone as their virtual key. Bluetooth technology is another wireless technology via smartphone to provide keyless entry. Tip 7, how many users on the system? The number of registered users will also influence your choice of intercom. Users may be defined as the number of residents, personnel, or the number of offices or apartments. The number of registered users will determine criteria such as the number of licenses required, perhaps the number of call buttons required, or digital phone book listings, and the scale and complexity of registration management. Tip 8, flush or surface mount. Choosing between flush or surface mount may simply be an aesthetic preference. However, there are other factors you should consider when choosing between the two. For example, ease of installation. A surface mount device would be the quickest and easiest installation option, as the device simply screws to the wall. Flush mounting requires additional labour, as the installer needs to cut a hole in the wall before fitting the back box, which is likely to have a significant impact on the cost and the time of installation per device. Another factor to consider is weather protection. Flush-mounted devices are likely to have a better protection from rain and bad weather conditions, as most of the device is covered inside the wall. However, rain hoods are available for many surface mount IP-rated devices, which add further protection from the elements. Similarly, flush-mounted devices are less likely to be at risk of accidental or deliberate damage due to the fact that the unit doesn't protrude from the wall, which makes it less likely to get knocked or caught by passers-by. Tip 9, wired or wireless. Even though some intercom models may be promoted as wireless, other than domestic devices like the Ring Smart Doorbell, there is currently no such thing as a fully wireless door intercom device. However, in order to reduce the amount of cabling required, particularly for installations located at gates or barriers some distance from the main building where Ethernet cable is unavailable, wireless data connectivity uses LTE technology, which is available in some door intercom models. Tip 10, aesthetics and size. A door intercom is usually the first point of contact for visitors entering a building. Therefore, the design and style of the door intercom device may be a key point to consider. For example, vandal-resistant models are most likely to have an industrial look about them, whereas other devices may be designed to provide an impressive first impression. Some intercoms also offer customizable features to match a company or building's branding. The size of the device is another factor to consider. For example, a larger building with unmanned entrances or lobby may require a larger eye-catching point of contact for visitors, whereas a smaller door intercom may be preferred where space is limited. Thanks for joining us at CIE's How to AV. If you need any more information or would like help choosing the right door intercom system, then please contact the CIE experts on the number below or visit us online at cie-group.com.